truly, and I'm not being facetious,
yes.
I don't know if there are movie stars anymore.
I don't think that's a facetious comment to make. I think it's true. I mean, I wouldn't call them movie stars today.
I sure wouldn't.
I would maybe call them something else.
I would say there are film actors.
There are film actors.
I would say there are film and streaming actors, of course, which, by the way, there's a difference. But I do think that the last great movie star is Brad Pitt.
There's an argument. I could see
I think there's an argument to be made. I think there's an argument to be made.
Yes, definitely Brad Pitt could. I could see it, but
then at the same time,
it's not
an argument against it too. Who is our generation's Paul Newman? Who's our generation's Cary Grant?
Yes,
who are some of these guys?
Paul Newman. I would like to see Brad Pitt bringing a baby. I would like to see it.
I would like to see it too.
I haven't seen it. I would like to. That would be a feast.
And by the way, at 50 some years old, he's killing it.
Oh,
I mean,
absolutely.
His body.
Absolutely. Hi.
His body is amazing, man.
Incredible body.
I would kill to look like that at 50-some.
I would say Paul Newman is all that and the proverbial bag of chips. That's what I would say. Understatement of the century. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
My week is hellish.
Oh, you can say that again. It's getting hot. It's getting hot up here, is it?
It is. Yeah, I guess it is.
I'm swamped.
I don't know what it is about this time of year. All of a sudden, it's like Screen Grab is emailing me. Silver Geek is emailing
Film
me.
Den Crusher.
I mean,
Den of Cinema. Cinema Lens.
Oh my God.
All of the different ones are emailing me trying to get a new review out of me. Something.
One man can only do so much.
I can only do so much.
What is that line? What is that famous
line?
Where
does it end? One man can do so much.
What is that from?
Yes, it's on the tip of my tongue.
What is that? Is that Orson?
I might be Orson.
I think that's
Orson.
It
might be Wells, yes. Orson Welles, yes.
One man can only do so much.
He can only do so much. Oh, beautiful.
No, my week is really hellish.
No,
man.
Yeah, mine too. I'm swamped.
What are you working on?
I'm doing the new review for Pearl for Screen Crusher, which is going to be really cool.
You are?
I am,
that's
yeah.
That's great.
Yeah,
that's
I'm
great.
Really excited.
I turned that down. So
you
that's
did,
great. I
you
mean,
did.
That's so cool
oh,
that you're
great.
Doing it.
No, yeah, no, it's just...
I just didn't have time on my... It, not because I think it's below me. I just
no,
think it's
no,
just
of
not...
No, no, of course.
I don't
yeah.
have time
yeah. who's
to
above,
it.
Who's above T. West?
Yes.
Nobody's
no
above
one.
T. West.
No
yeah.
one. No, I mean, what he's doing right now is so fucking cool. And
oh, it's
the
so
fact
sick.
That I got to sit down with him, actually, at Sundance
oh, you did.
Was so cool.
Oh, you sat down with him at Sundance.
I sat down with him at Sundance.
That's interesting.
He is just, I mean, he's
Isn't,
a student of cinema, and it was just really
kind of
fucking
recluse,
cool to pick
though.
His brain.
He's pretty, he's pretty
He is. He wasn't at Sundance, but he was.
He wasn't there?
He sat down.
But you sat down
We
with
talked
him.
On the phone, yeah.
And
I
you
was
talked
at
on the phone. Interesting.
He,
interesting.
I didn't
cool.
catch him at Sundance, but I caught up with him while I was
there
at Sundance,
okay,
yeah.
Okay, interesting.
No, but I got a lot of stuff too, actually.
Oh yeah, you do?
So.
I'm always so excited to read your work.
Thank you, man. Thank you.
No, what are you working
on? Well, I'm doing a piece for The Grubber.
The Grubber, oh.
They asked me to do the top 10 elevated horror movies of the 2010s.
Film Lens might have done that already. Didn't they do that already?
They did, but they did a different take on
they
it.
Did a
I mean,
take. Doing
they,
a thing.
Yeah, I'm doing a different thing. I'm more exploring elevated horror as a genre.
Oh, sure.
And getting into
sure.
what makes that sort of the.
You might want to read. You read the piece. You read the Film Lens piece.
I skimmed it when it came out.
You
yeah.
might want to read that because it's a little similar to what you're saying. It's a little similar. You just might. It's just. I'm sure you'll have your own take. It's. Mm-hmm. It's just. It's really nice. It's always so nice reading your work. It's. You always have a new take, and it's so. It's always like spicy, you know, spicy in a great way. So, but I mean, you should definitely.
No, I'll check that
definitely
out.
Check
I'll
it
check
out.
That out. I do think my take will be much different.
Sure.
But I'll check that out anyway.
Sure, sure. I actually got put on the new email list for
yeah,
the
that's
readers.
Great.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry for what exactly?
The new email list for the screeners. You got? Were you not on this list? It like
I think I was. I just switched stuff from like, wait, what?
It's got like the new House of Dragon and the new Rings of Power, and like it's like even it's way more inclusive in the
wait,
second
sorry,
season.
rewind.
Yeah.
What? How'd you get on the Rings of Power?
The second season?
Yeah.
You didn't get on that list?
I may have.
Yeah, you should check your spam. Might be in your spam.
Yeah,
but
no,
it didn't
I may
end
have,
up in my
yeah.
spam. It was at the top of my email list when I got put on. But I also knew Goldstein put me on.
Goldstein put you on?
Goldstein put me on. Yeah, we go back. We're kind of friends, old buddies from college. So he's just like, oh, are you on this list? And I was like, no, I'm not. Oh, sick. Rings of Power. Yeah. Yeah, so I'm probably going to end up reviewing one of those for whether it be CinemaLens or Screen Killer or any of those. You're sure you're not on this list? You're not on that list.
He probably knew I was busy this week.
That's probably it. Yeah. And you said it was hellish for you. Yeah.
Yeah.
So he probably knew you were busy, probably. I mean, yeah. Ugh. What is it? What is that? What is that?
Dates?
Why are you eating dates? No, I'm okay.
My wife put me on a diet.
Oh.
It sucks. Maybe that was a bad one. Ugh.
It looks the same.
You know, I sat down with Seth Rogen at Telluride last year, and he said something really interesting.
Oh, you
which
sat
is
down with
comedy.
Rogan.
I did.
That's I yes. And we're good friends, me and Rogen. Rogen and I are.
Really?
Yeah, yeah. We talked about marijuana here.
I've talked to him about that too. Yes.
Who is this
he
man?
Draws
who?
You in yes. with that iconic. With the that iconic Seth Rogen laugh.
The iconic laugh.
Which also, I mean, that's an interest. That could be an interesting piece. Also, is iconic laughs of the of the 2010s.
I would say, I think
that could be really interesting.
I could see Seth Rogen making that laugh.
I mean, who?
Absolutely.
Who's your top five? Here's the question: does Fran Drescher count? Or is
that's
that,
interesting because 2010s Fran Drescher isn't quite the same.
It isn't quite the same. We haven't seen
not
her.
Really the nanny.
She
not.
Did make that pivot to activism and
yes,
to the political side of things.
Absolutely, absolutely. And that doesn't really bring out laughs as much. So I could see her cracking
well,
five.
I, my not, friend, I will say politics does bring out laughs,
that
unfortunately.
That is a good point. That is a good point.
Do I think it should bring out laughs?
Absolutely.
No.
That's a different.
No.
Yes, yes.
Do I think that it is pretty funny when I turn on the news and I see some of the stuff that's going on? Yeah,
yeah
in a morbid
I
way,
think,
sure.
Yes. Gearing up for a massive episode of the pod.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, you know my
what's
pod,
it about?
Right? It's the dork
the
side.
Oh,
the dork
yeah.
side,
yeah. Yeah, yeah,
yeah. Each episode yeah. takes a new in-depth look on one of Marvel's biggest baddies.
Very
you
cool.
Know? Very
yes.
cool, right?
I'm familiar. I haven't listened, but I've been meaning to check it out.
Oh, you should definitely check it out.
Totally.
You should definitely check it. It's like we just finished an epic episode about Loki.
Oh, yeah.
Brother
that's
of
great.
Thor, Loki.
Oh, yes.
We
of
just
course.
Finished that.
The God of Chaos.
The God of Chaos.
Norse
yes.
God of Chaos.
Absolutely.
Yes.
And
I
we're
know
gearing
him very
up.
Well.
Of course, yes. Yeah. Who doesn't? But we've got this pretty epic episode, this massive behemoth of an episode on a two-parter on Thanos coming up. Yeah.
Really?
It's going to be pretty legendary, I think. I think the fans will lose it.
Definitely. I mean, you saw my piece about Thanos, right?
Oh,
just comparing
yeah.
him to Donald Trump and the rise of authoritarianism.
Yes, authoritarianism, yes.
Yeah.
No, I was meaning to check that out. I was meaning to check that out.
You should
yes.
check it out. No, it sheds light on... I mean, I don't want to get into it.
You've read...
You don't... I mean, you have a guest.
You've
you
read,
have a guest already?
You've read Gilstein's piece, no? On it? On
no.
Thanos and
oh,
kind
no.
of the real-life implications of...
Oh, you know, it's open on a tab on my computer.
Yeah.
I've been meaning to.
Yeah, we're getting Gilstein on because he wrote that long-form piece. And, you know, it
Gilstein.
Kind of... It would kind of be rude not to, you know? He kind of wrote the definitive Thanos, authoritarian, sort of piece. And I actually didn't know that you were into podcasts at all. You podcast?
Yeah, no, I am. I thought you would have seen... stupid. I just launched one, but...
Oh, nice. Yeah, it's called... A Patreon?
No, just free.
Wow.
Wherever you get podcasts.
Man of the people.
Yeah. No, it's called Are You Talking to Me? And we talk about Tolkien, Marvel.
Excellent name.
Conversation always spins out. It's super fun and
so cool.
Yeah.
Oh, this stretch is great for my hamstring, you know?
You know, we could do a quid pro quo maybe. You could guess on mine, I can guess on yours.
Absolutely. I'll definitely put you on the spreadsheet. We'll definitely...
Let's get it in the books.
I legitimately think the fans will go apeshit.
Let's get it in the books.
I think it will blow some minds.
Let's get that.
I would love to do a podcast with you. I would love to do an episode. Dorkside needs you.
Make it happen, man.
All right.
Make it happen. You want to do a lap?
Yeah. I had this Q&A that I was offered to do with the great Nicolas Cage.
Okay.
And Nicolas Cage talks about this because you've seen him be funny.
Nick can be very funny.
He can be.
I mean, this is such an interesting dichotomy. In one way, it is big,
yes.
In that there are these big facial expressions.
Yes.
There are these big, let's think of Moonstruck.
Yes.
And in another way, it's very subtle because they're not jokes per se.
They aren't.
It's not comedy outright.
You wouldn't see Nicolas Cage being the host of the Tonight Show. You wouldn't see that.
No.
I'm somewhat close with Jeremy Strong, for instance, and I could see him. I could see him absolutely bristling. He's an absolutely fascinating character.
And I've met him too, actually, and he's a colleague in a way of mine as well.
And so
I actually spoke to Keanu's trainer.
His trainer
at Telluride last year. They had just
done
Wick, and his trainer was telling me, I mean, speaking of great movie stars, Keanu, who, by the way, looks great at his age.
Amazing. An incredible body.
Hi.
An incredible body.
Oh, this is pretty cool. I think you're going to take this.
Oh, yeah?
I sat down with John Barenthal.
Barenthal?
At Telluride.
No way.
Yeah, no big deal.
That is exciting.
Just John Barenthal, the Punisher. Okay.
Okay.
Sitting across
the Punisher
from him.
I'm is in front of me.
Questions.
Okay.
Yeah. Meanwhile, trying that to keep my exciting. Composure. He told me this thing. He didn't tell any of the other press, none of the interviewers. He just opened up to me about this. He says he only... When he gets a script, he highlights his lines, right?
Of course.
Only uses blue highlighter. Doesn't use yellow. Doesn't use pink.
No
way. Can only use blue. He says, I can't. He's like,
what happens if he uses another color?
I use yellow, I use pink. I can't read it.
No way.
He says, something about the blue draws me in.
That is so interesting.
I just thought that was so fascinating.
That is so fascinating. Just a peek behind, like a peek into his mind.
Yes, exactly.
That's
to how the
beautiful.
Punisher thinks. He says, I only use blue.
That's insane.
What?
You know, that is actually quite insane that you bring up Barenthal and this highlighter thing, because I had a bit of a celebrity run-in myself.
No way.
Yeah.
Tell me about it.
So I went Whole Foods, the ball and chain had me getting some groceries, just a classic, and who do I run into other than Sofia Coppola's assistant? Yes.
That's so fucking cool.
I'm a bundle of nerves, you know? I have no idea. But I see this pen sticking out of her pocket. She's wearing a jacket. And I see this pen sticking out of her pocket.
Yeah.
And I go, oh, I can't believe I have pen to run into you here. Because the pen is sticking out.
Right. Wait, that's so fucking funny.
I don't know how I came up with that. I was so nervous.
My heart is... racing as you were saying
that. I couldn't believe
that's Sofia Coppola's assistant.
I know.
Oh my God.
And I love the Coppolas and their family.
Oh my God. I mean,
everything.
Francis
yeah.
Ford, Apocalypse Now.
I love them, yeah.
I mean, that's so goddamn awesome. To think that you made her giggle, and she's got that in her head. She comes home to Sophia, says it to her. And like, that's fucking cool, man. You should be really proud of yourself. Were you just like on cloud nine? Were you over the moon? Like, hello?
Oh, sorry.
Earth to Mars.
Sorry. Sorry about that.
I guess you were over the moon. You're in space just now. Where were you, Space Cadet? What's going on?
It's so stupid. I don't know. I was at the Whole Foods, I was saying, right? Just got me thinking. I was my wife and, you know, Molly, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. Things aren't, like, amazing right now between us. Just, like, going through something. She wanted to get this dog.
Yeah. That's great. What's the problem?
I thought it was great. This dog does not like me. This dog is barking at me loud. Like, really loud. Oh. Every time I come into the house. And, you know, we got this dog kind of as, like, something because we were feeling a little distant. And she was like, oh, it would be so fun to have a dog around the house. And it was, yeah, sure.
Uh-huh.
We go to the rescue, and she picks the one that immediately starts barking at me, like, so loud.
That's so terrible, man. Look.
Thanks.
I'm not good at giving advice, but when Loki and Thor are on the outs, they always find their way back to each other. This dog sounds like chaos. He does, okay?
God of chaos.
As much as Molly might think otherwise, as much as you might want to believe he's capable of change, he's going to be how he's going to be. He's got that Loki energy in him. Look, you got a heart of gold, man. You're like Thor, okay? I've always thought that. And
that's...
even when
that means so much,
you and I have our issues sometimes.
We come back. Loki and Thor, they always find a way. That's so true. Thank you. That
man, you're tense, man. You want a date or something? I don't know.
Yeah,
I got these dates, but
oh yeah,
just take one. I feel like.
Oh,
you got to recharge. You're feeding
sure.
this dog all the time.
Yeah.
I think
I'll
you
have
can
a
have a
Why
date
not?
As a treat.
Yeah. Why not? You just pop it in?
Yeah, just pop it in and.
I don't like that.
No.
I don't like that. No.
I don't like it either, man.
You know, you'd think this dog is barking at me because I'm not feeding him, but that's
right.
Actually the opposite of what's true. I feed this dog a lot. Bowl after bowl after bowl, and he barks louder at me. He gets more mad at me the more I feed him. The more I feed him.
The food is fueling the barking.
The food is fueling the barking. That's a great way of putting it. The food is absolutely fueling the barking.
Well, look, man, I mean, you cut off that fuel, you cut off his power source.
That is interesting. I should stop. You're saying I should
stop
feeding the dog.
I'm just saying if you stop feeding him.
I should stop feeding the dog.
You stop feeding the dog.
That's interesting.
You cut off his power source. He stops barking.
I'm going to stop feeding my dog. That's a fantastic way to look at it.